Hello and welcome. My name is Kia and I'm coming to you from Sweden in a small village outside of Gothenburg. And I wanted to show you how I am doing with my supported spindel. I just recently, a couple of weeks ago, started to spin on a supported spindel. And I wanted to show you how I am doing. And this is how far I am on my spinning here. And I have a spindel like this, and I am putting it in that thing and spinning like this. And I am going to show you now how I am drawing the fiber to prepare it to spin. So this is Polworth, and I am just picking a piece here. And I am pre-drafting it, so it's getting easier to spin. Yeah, I can start with that. So here you can see I have been stretching out the fibers for a easier spin. So I am making a little nest in my right hand, and I am having my spindel, my bowl here, in a bigger bowl so I can keep control over it. And I'm keeping it behind my legs, and inside I have this little thing for the spindel to spin in. And I just make sure I have some fluffy fiber here to start with. And then I just put a little spin on the spindel to make sure I get the fibers to grip. And it can be interesting, I think, not only to see professional spin, but to see a beginner. So what I have been doing to learn is I have prepared this fiber, and I'm spinning, I'm holding a grip here, putting spin on the fiber, and then I am drafting the fiber a bit. So I keep a little spin, and after that I park it. You call it to park here, and after when you're full on your parking, I will show you to wind it down to the bottom of your spindle. But this is how I am doing now. Since I am a beginner, I have not got a very good technique yet, but I still think it can be interesting, because I was looking for, when I was beginning to spin on this spindle, I was looking on YouTube for beginner friendly clips. And I think that we are all beginners in the beginning, and that's also something that we can show. And when I want to move this, I have quite a bit of fibers here. I just roll it over my mini finger and my thumb, and like this. So I am moving all my parked thread over to the hand. Oops. And I am winding it up again down here. And if you look at the professionals, they have a very nice thing down here. Mine is not so very nice, but it's what I have. Yeah, and then you attach some new fibers. This is a good way, I think, to not be stressed when you start with the spindel, because I started with the hanging spindel and I didn't have time to take care of the fibers, to draw the fibers. I was very stressed with the spindel, starting to spin back the other way again. So I think this is good because I can stop here and I can take care of. So I have good twist now on this one, so I am just rolling it up on the parking place, and then I put a little spin again on the spindle. So this is how far I am with my practicing of spinning on supported spindle, and I am really enjoying it. We are having a lovely evening here in Sweden, and to find a place like this in the shadow and sit and spin, that's a good way to spend the Saturday night, I think. You get a new way of thinking of yarn when you are spinning on a spindle. That's totally different from also from spinning on a spinning wheel, because that's very quick. When you spin with this with the spindle, you're happy with every meter that you produce. When you are sitting behind the wheel, you don't really think about the meters because they go so quickly. Here you're happy with every little meter that you produce. So I should say about 10 hours I have been practicing, maybe absolutely the most 15 hours, since I never touched a supported spindle. And now I am actually, I can spin on a supported spindle, but I am absolutely not very good at it yet, but I'm practicing and I'm learning. I am removing the parking again, and maybe I will move this from one spindle to my nystepinne. I hope you find it nice to see a beginner do some spinning, because on YouTube there is only professionals, but I am a total beginner on supported spindles, but I'm learning and I'm practicing. So this is my spindle. And my yarn that I have done here. I am just letting my spindle lay loose in this ball. That's how I do it for now. I haven't figured out a better way. So here is my finished little ball, and I draw from the middle here. And if I want to ply this, when I have two of these, I can just pull in the middle from my both little balls and ply. And this time I left a bit here so I have something to start from, because I have more fibers that I'm going to spin. So when I start now, I have something to begin with. So it makes it a bit easier. Well, I hope you enjoyed that little video. And if you like what you see, you can always hit the thumbs up and the subscribe button if you want to see more of this. Maybe I will put up some more videos in the future when I have done some more practice with my supported spindle. Bye bye!